So, just so you know, I think that the astrology they're working with isn't mine, but the pension fund is my father's, right? They stole my retirement fund, and so I don't really have a backup except to say I already know that this is what they set up. I've already told the guy that I already know it. What am I supposed to say? I think I'm supposed to be a fat gay sailor, and I think I qualify. Is this supposed to be some sort of limerick from Cork? I think that's the case, right? All right. So here's the situation with this Spygate. I'm just going to say it bluntly. Let's say you find out one day that you aren't American. You weren't born in, you weren't really from America. And when you were a kid, some people came up with a very high-level project. They have this thing where they say that their kid is their bond. Now, it may or may not be a part of the culture you came from, but somebody made some decision that certain kids were going to be taken from the country that they were born in and that their family and their life is from, and they were going to be given to people in other countries to be adopted. And you were one of these kids. Now, there's a couple of things that I have a theory happen. Country you come from had a very complicated relationship with religion. There were people that had been persecuted because of the government making religion basically illegal, if not literally illegal. And while some people were able to practice and they were able to do things that were part of their religious tradition, it was contained. And there could potentially be consequences if it wasn't done in a certain way. And not only that, but within particular kinds of religion, there was persecution regarding other religions, right? So, you may come from a background that was, for instance, Jewish, but under an old system, those Jews were persecuted and forced to convert to Christendom. And then a new system came in and made religion illegal and started to persecute Christians. It's also possible that you come from a situation where your family actually believed in that regime that didn't believe in any state-sponsored religion or any sort of religious situation. But for whatever reason, when you were taken as a kid, you were baptized anyway. You were baptized as a baby. And then you were sent to another country. And when you went to that other country, you were given to parents that were very, very different from the place where you came from. Now, if I'm correct, what I'm referencing right now means you were probably given to parents that might have been considered heretics or apostates or sinful or counter-revolutionary. The height of bourgeois decadence in the country that you came from. Now, I don't know if your parents actually told you, your adopted parents actually told you. I don't know if they ever told you you were adopted from another country. I don't know if they told you that the country you came from had a very different way of life, and that actually, if you were to go to that country today, there might be complications in terms of how they would see you. There might be some hostility. There might be some consideration that they intentionally put you into a context that was 100% contrary or very contrary to what your birth parents and your community where you came from was because they wanted to corrupt you. They wanted to hack you. They wanted to take your actual lineage and your actual legacy and the actual gifts that you had and could contribute, and they wanted to completely rewrite them in what would have been considered where you come from to be the enemy. And then, of course, you have to deal with the fact that even within where you came from, there were enemies. And they're going to try, some people, to say, well, that's what you're dealing with now. It's oppression. right? Social justice, civil rights. Maybe your parents are different, right? I mean, maybe in your local neighborhood, the local community, they're not different. But outside of that, there's an experience of oppression. I have a feeling you're the spy. You're the spy. You're probably what now? Teenager? I don't think you're even old enough to run for Congress. You may not even be of legal drinking age. Maybe some of you are either just in college or you're about to go to college, and you're the fucking spies. And you've got a bunch of perverts in what's supposed to be the government that you're supposed to be loyal to, trying to make you demonstrate your loyalty, aren't they? Yes. Are you pleasuring the president? Or do you think the president's a very bad man, so you're committed to supporting the appropriate political operative to which you've been assigned or offered? I absolutely believe that that's what this whole Russian hacking, Russian spy shit is. And the thing is, a lot of you aren't Russian, are you? Yeah, right? But, you know, from the United States, it's all the same. All that stuff, it was all the same. I really think that's what they've done. Now, at some point, it got confused. Because you're a lot younger than me. But somebody wants me to believe that I'm one of you. That I was, like, first generation. That I was, like, actually some, like, star kid or something. And a fucking meteorite crashed near my mama. And while I was sleeping in the manger or something. And, you know, some sort of, like, cosmic things got going on. And that they abducted me when I was a little kid. And they brought me to the United States. And they tried to raise me with a family structure. It was completely different. And that my dad might be somebody that's in this country specifically as an agent of a foreign government. And I was raised all of my life to believe that he's actually my biological dad and he's actually American. And he was actually born in America and my mom was actually born in America and had a very specific kind of American, typical American family background. So did my dad. And, you know, but that was all a lie, right? And my dad's not really my dad. My mom's not really my mom. And that they were really, that my dad was really a Russian spy. And my dad was like, but the thing was, he was a Russian spy, but everybody knew he was a Russian spy. Except he wasn't Russian, right? He was Ukrainian, right? So this is part of the genesis, part of the psyop. How many of these permutations can you work to create the optimal amount of rationales so that some broker that's in the portfolio, your mom and your mom's lawyer used to work with, can spin you around to help their perverts in public office defraud the actual American government while they parse it out into contracts for all those people that are flipping you right now? What are you going to do? Right? What are you going to do?